Walt Disney will step forward to read the dedication of Disneyland.
To all who come to this happy place, welcome. Disneyland is your land. Here age relives fond memories of the past, and here youth may savor the challenge and promise of the future. Disneyland is dedicated to the ideals, the dreams, and the hard facts that have created America, with the hope that it will be a source of joy and inspiration to all the world. Thank you.
65 years ago on this day, the world was forever changed. Walter Elias Disney, a man who had grown from humble roots in Marceline, Missouri, had a dream. As a young boy, he spent much of his time drawing pictures of the animals he saw day to day growing up on the family farm. Walt never stopped drawing. Not when he had to wake up at 4:30 a.m. to deliver newspapers with his brother Roy, then go to school. Not when he had to lie about his age and enlisted in the Red Cross to work as an ambulance driver. He was shipped to France and drew cartoon characters on the side of the ambulance. He even had some of his drawings published in the Army newspaper, Stars and Stripes. Walt always found an opportunity to do what he loved, no matter the situation that he was in. He began his animation journey in 1919 as an apprentice at the Pessman Rubin Animation Studio, and eventually created his own studio, Iwerks Disney Commercial Studio. Though this studio was short-lived, it didn't stop Disney from following his dream of becoming an animator. Walt went on to develop a new studio, Laugh-O-Grams, where he created the short film, Alice's Wonderland. This 12-minute film combined both live-action and cartoon animation, and through its success, Walt and Roy created what would become the Walt Disney Company. Always striving to outdo himself, Walt grew tired of animating short cartoons. He wanted to animate something longer. He wanted to create the world's first feature-length animated film. And so, the four-year-long journey to produce Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs began. Many believed the film would leave the Walt Disney Company bankrupt. The production of Snow White cost $1.5 million, but when the film debuted in 1937, it was a complete success. By 1939, Snow White had grossed $6.5 million. Besides animation, another great passion of Walt's was railroads. He loved them so much, in fact, that he set out to have one built in his own backyard. He named the steam-powered engine after his wife, Lillian, and named it the Lily Bell. This would not be the last time Walt would build a steam engine railroad, though. It has been said that the conception of Disneyland first came to Walt on a park bench. While visiting Griffith Park in Los Angeles with his two daughters, Walt dreamed of a place where both children and parents could have fun. This park would not be in the likes of Coney Island, no. Walt's park would be pristine. It would be clean. The staff would be well put together. Families would feel like they were on vacation. This park would be like no other theme park in the United States. To ensure this, Walt sent his Imagineers out to every theme park in the U.S. They were tasked to analyze their park and figure out what worked well and what didn't. After finally settling on a plot of land in Anaheim, California, construction of Disneyland began in July of 1954. Construction took exactly 1 year, and on July 17th, 1955, Disneyland opened, ready to welcome the public inside. Well, it was almost ready. In truth, construction was heavily rushed. Some attractions like Peter Pan's Flight and Dumbo weren't open, much to the dismay of many children. Other attractions crashed and burned. Literally. Aggressive drivers on Autopia caused the wreckage of almost every car on the attraction. The hot Southern California sun had reached over 100 degrees, which caused the freshly placed asphalt to melt into tar, entrapping ladies' heels into the ground. And to make matters even stickier, pun intended, someone had created and sold counterfeit Disneyland tickets. It was predicted that about 15,000 guests would visit on opening day, but due to the sale of counterfeit tickets and the man who charged $5 to help you hop over the gates on his ladder, about 28,000 people visited instead. The park was way past its predicted capacity for the day. This caused attractions like the Mark Twain riverboat to overflow with people. The boat began sinking and guests had to be escorted off. Disneyland's opening day would be known as Black Sunday. Although everything that could possibly go wrong went wrong, this did not stop Walt from moving forward. He tirelessly worked with his team to get the park operating smoothly. Although there continued to be bumps along the way, this certainly did not stop families from visiting. Within just 7 weeks of being opened, Disneyland welcomed 1 million guests through its gates. And as of December 2018, that number has skyrocketed to more than 750 million. Since its opening, Disneyland has seen many changes to its layout. It opened with Main Street USA, Adventureland, Frontierland, Tomorrowland, and Fantasyland. Over the years, there have been many additions, such as New Orleans Square, added in 1966, Critter Country, formerly known as Bear Country, in 1972, Mickey's Toontown in 1993, and the most recent installment, Star Wars Galaxy's Edge, added in 2019. In February 2001, Disney welcomed the opening of its sister park, Disneyland's California Adventure, or DCA for short, which has gone through drastic changes within the short amount of time that it's been opened. Now, Walt once said, "Disneyland will never be completed. It will continue to grow as long as there is imagination left in the world." Disneyland continues to evolve. 65 years later, and it still manages to capture the hearts of all of those who have the opportunity to experience it. For many, Disneyland truly is the happiest place on earth. It's created a safe haven for those who need comfort, a place where one can leave behind the stress and worries of the real world and step into a bubble of hope, adventure, and love. In these current times, where we live day to day with uncertainty and fear, Disneyland continues to provide comfort to those of us who consider it our second home. And although we can't celebrate Disneyland's 65th anniversary inside the park, we can still celebrate what it stands for. We remain hopeful and look forward to the day that we can once again embrace, eat a churro, meet our favorite character, and watch a fireworks show. Did Walt Disney ever imagine the community he would pave the way for? Did he ever imagine that people from all over the world would one day come together because of the love they all share for something that he created? Thank you, Walt Disney. Without your dream, I wouldn't have found my Disney Ohana. Happy 65th anniversary.
Walt, you've made a bum out of Barnum today, but we've got to go.
I know, but I just want to say a word of thanks to all the artists, the workers, and everybody that helped make this dream come true.
Let's go into Fantasyland and have some fun. Goodbye, folks.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come.